Teaching Christian Basics, Lesson 2, The Different Ways We Know About God. There are two different ways that we know about God. The first we call the natural knowledge of God, and that is what we can know about God apart from His revealed knowledge, the Scriptures. And the second is, I've given it away already, the second knowledge of God is the Scriptures, or the revealed knowledge of God. So we can learn about God through nature, and we can learn about God through His revelation in the Scriptures. Now, when it comes to the natural knowledge of God, we want to make a couple of distinctions. The first is what we can know outside of ourselves and what we know inside of ourselves. There's the external knowledge of God. That has to do with looking at the stars in the sky, with studying creation, with even with thinking about things philosophically and reasonably. That would be the external knowledge of God. And then there's the internal knowledge of God. That is the knowledge of God that we have in our conscience, the knowledge of right and wrong, the knowledge that there's a judgment to come at the end of the world, the knowledge that there's an order in the universe and I don't fit in with that order. So the natural knowledge of God is both internal and external. We can also make this distinction with the natural knowledge of God, that it's both acquired and innate. Some things we know naturally. That's especially has to do with the conscience and our own station in life, our own failures in life to live up to the requirements of God. And then there's the acquired knowledge of God, those things which we learn about through study, through inquiry, through reason and rational thinking. So the external knowledge of God is acquired knowledge. The internal knowledge of God is an innate knowledge of God. Now, the other thing we want to know about the natural knowledge of God is that it is very limited. We only can know a few things about God. Namely, this is how I like to think about it, that God is big, He created the universe, that God is good. That means there's a particular order to the universe, and because we do not live according to that ordered universe, God is mad. God is the judge. So that God is big, good, and mad. Now, what you might notice there is that the grace of God is not revealed. In fact, the saving knowledge of God is not revealed through nature. It is only revealed through the Scriptures. So Paul says, for example, in Romans 1:18, the wrath of God is revealed against all ungodliness of men. So we want to make sure that to talk about the saving knowledge of God, we talk about the revealed knowledge of God, the preaching of the gospel, which comes to us through the prophets and the apostles. So there's the two different ways we know about God, the natural knowledge of God and the revealed knowledge of God. We know that the natural knowledge of God is both external and internal and acquired and innate, and that it is very limited, that we only know that God is good, big, and mad, and we can't know that God is gracious. We can't know the persons of the Holy Trinity. We can't know the deep mysteries of the Christian faith apart from the Scriptures. That's what we're going to talk about in the next lesson 3, the doctrine of the Scriptures.